Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how to merge video clips in iMovie. So let's dive in by first assuming that you already have your clips in a project in iMovie. If you don't worry, I'll show you how to do that in a minute. But let's say you've got all your clips here in your My Media section, and you just want to merge them all together in one long video. You could do that pretty quickly by first selecting one of these clips just to make sure that you've got this area active. Then use Command A for Select All. Now drag the clips in to the timeline here at the bottom, and you'll see it'll place them one after the other like this. So now you have a project where all of the clips are in fact merged. They're one right after the other. All you need to do at this point is go to File and then Share and then File. So in other words, export it as a file. Make sure you have it set to the highest resolution for the project. You want the quality to be high, and you want compression to be better quality. Now go to Next, and then name the file and export it. When that's done, you'll have the video wherever it is that you decided to save it, and you can open it up and see that all of the clips are in there one after the other. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MACMOST at Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. Now, I know some people do this so they can simply work with one clip in iMovie. If you want to do that, then you would delete everything in the timeline and then select all of these clips again, and then go to File and Delete Media from Event. That clears out all of your clips there. You can then drag this one new unified video in there, and you have all of your clips together as one long clip that you can work with. There's a problem with this though. You've taken compressed video and you've recompressed it by exporting it from iMovie. So the quality has been reduced either a little bit or it could be a lot depending upon the quality of the original video. Now this is perfectly fine for just a fun home project, but for doing anything more serious, you want to work with the original clips. So while you may like the workflow of having this one long clip to work with in iMovie, stick with the individual clips, learn to edit that way for the best quality of your final video. Now let's take a step back and start a project from scratch. So you launch iMovie and you create a brand new project. You make it a movie project. And now you have what I showed before, except there's nothing here in your media. You've got your media right here. It's just named the same thing as your project, but it's empty. To get clips in here, you could do it one of several ways. One is you could just click here where it says Import Media, or use File, Import Media. It gets you to the same place. Then you can navigate to where you have your file. So for instance, I have in my Documents folder a Videos folder right here, and I could select these. I'll hold the Shift key down to select all of them, and I could import all. And when I do, I get all of these in here just like at the start of this video. Another thing you can do is just drag and drop files from the Finder. So I've got a Finder window here. It's got those same files in it. I will select them all and then drag into my media right here, and it adds all the clips. You could also just drag directly into the timeline. And when it does it, it adds it to the clips and adds it to the timeline at the same time, saving you a step. I also want to mention that you could select Photos here on the left, and it will take you to your Photos library. It'll show you all your photos, but you probably want to go here to where it shows all and select only videos if you know you just want video clips. Select one that you want, and you'll get this plus button here. You can click that or just drag the entire thing into the timeline. Once you do, if you go back to your project media, you'll see that it's added it there as well. And you could, of course, mix and match these. Add a couple videos from your Photos library, drag a couple files from the Finder, use the import function to go and find some more. If you have your clips in your project media, you can of course do what I showed before and select them all and drag them all in, but you can also drag them one at a time. That allows you to choose the order in which they appear. You can adjust this slider here to shrink the timeline to make it easier to add them like that. And then once they're in this timeline, they're not set in this order either. You can select one and drag it left or right to reorder them. On a quick tip here, in Photos, you can actually add photos as well. So if you select a photo and drag that in, what it's going to do is place the photo there as a still image for a few seconds. You can then grab the right end and extend the time to make it there longer. You could also drag and drop images from the Finder and add them in as well, so you're not restricted to just videos. Once you have your clips in here, you're also not stuck with having the entire clip. You can grab the right side of a clip and drag it to the left to trim from the end of the clip. You could also grab the left side of the clip and trim from the beginning of the clip. You can even do this before you add clips. So you can select a clip here and then drag the right side, and you can see a preview of it over here. You can drag the left side as well. It's just the area in this yellow rectangle then that will be added when you drag a clip to the timeline. And notice too that you can have the same clip more than once. You can also split a clip by just clicking to position the line here and using Command B, and it will split the clip into two. You can then take the second half of that clip and move it later or even earlier in the sequence. And anytime you want, you can select a clip and then just use the delete key to remove it. Add it back again by dragging it from up here. Now with each of these clips, it cuts directly to the next clip. One frame is the previous clip, and then the very next frame is the next clip. You can add transitions pretty easily. Click on transitions here at the top. You can drag a transition to any spot between any two clips like that. And now the last few seconds of this clip will transition, in this case using a cross dissolve, into the next one. You can add a transition to multiple clips at once by simply selecting those clips. I can select one here and then command click to select others, or shift click to select a range, or just command A to select them all. And then instead of dragging the transition, double click to add it. When I double click cross dissolve, you could see it adds it everywhere. It even cross dissolves from black at the beginning and to black at the end. Another useful tip is just use command T, which automatically adds a cross dissolve transition. So select a clip, command T will add it at the beginning and end of that clip. Select all with command A, and then a quick command T will add a cross dissolve to all of them. One last tip is that if your videos are of different resolutions, for instance, some are 4K and some are 1080, it's very important to pay attention to which clip you add first. For instance, the only clip here that is 4K is this one with the flag in it. If I were to select all of these and then add them, the first clip being added is this one, which is 1080. If I click on settings now, I could see that the project is set to 1080. And when I go to file and then share and then file, I can only export at 1080 at best. But if instead I added the 4K clip first, then I added the other clips like this, now if I go to settings, notice the project settings are 4K. It follows the first clip added. And if I go to file, share, file, then you see I can actually export in 4K. It won't improve the quality of the other clips, but they won't be any worse. And I'll get that first clip in its full resolution. And note, just because you added that clip first doesn't mean you can't now rearrange things. So drag this clip later on, and the first clip is now 1080, but it was the first clip I added to the timeline that set the project as 4K. So that's how you merge a bunch of video clips into one movie in iMovie. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.